Hi everyone and welcome back to one of my most popular features in this channel where I am creating 10 cards out of one card kit. So today I'm featuring the Spellbinders February card kit. Just like always, we are going to take a quick look on all the goodies that you get in the kit, and then I will create 10 cards using most of the products. So you always get a leaflet where you can see some ideas on how you can make a few cards. Here are your basics such as foam tape, tape adhesive, as well as 10 cards pre-folded in a standard card size and 10 envelopes, all in white. Now you will also get a little jar of confetti. These are sequins in silver and pink colors. Great for adding a little sparkle on your cards as well as for shaker cards. And these are the dies for this month. Now if you put together these dies, you are going to create a really unique looking unicorn. And you even get tiny little flower dies to decorate your unicorn or any other project, as well as a couple of sentiments. Now, if you are wondering how to put this design together, fear not, there is the leaflet and it has full instructions on how you can make your little unicorn. In the kit there is a pack of those cards. These are like the Project Life cards. They are 3x4 with lovely designs both sides. I absolutely love the color combination in this kit. And I'm going quickly through them, but you can see just a quick peek on how they look. I will be using lots of them for my cards today, as I will be doing lots of paper piecing along with the die cuts that are included in the kit. And let's take a look at the paper pad for this month, again in the same color combination as the cards. There are 20 different designs. Some of them are specialty paper, so you can see they have foiling on top. There are 40 pages in this paper pad. This is 6x6. You get 20 designs, 2 pages for each design, and they are not double-sided, as you can see. Lovely happy colors. Spellbinders kits usually include stickers, so this time you get 3 pages. The first page has dimensional stickers, the second has sentiment strips, and the third page has a variety of sentiments and banners. And here is the clear stamp set for today. It includes a lovely unicorn design, stars, rainbows, hearts, as well as lots of sentiments. There are 9 different colors of cardstock, one of them is a gold one. And of course they coordinate with the color combination of the kit. Now I'm going to put everything aside and I'm going to lay all over my table the die cuts, which I absolutely love and I can't wait every month to play with them. Here they are all together, bright and colorful. You get each design twice, so you have plenty of die cuts to play along and create way more than 10 cards that I'm going to show you today. Now, just like every month, the cards are going to be super quick and simple, really easy to replicate, and you will be able to make them even if you are a beginner. So for the first card, I'm going to combine 2 of those journaling cards. I'm using some foam tape at the back, and I'm going to stick one on top of the other in an angle so that I can see some color peeking through from the back. And the piece of cake is the exact same design as the one on the paper, so I just had to pop that with foam tape directly on top, cover up the design underneath, but at the same time I'm adding some dimension. So just to finish it off, I am going to stick it on top of a standard card, one of the ones that are included in the kit. I'm going to move it around until I'm happy with the placement, and then I'm going to add a few of the die-cut stars. Just to embellish it a little bit more, these have some foiling on top, so they are nice and shiny. Now to finish it off, I'm going to add some glossy accents where the flame is, and I'm going to call this card done. Now as I'm looking through the die cuts, I try to find things that match together. So you can see you get a palette as well as a couple of brushes, and this lovely card with those colorful pencils that say, "You color me happy." Now I'm going to combine all of these with this pattern paper from the pad. It has all those color splashes, and I think that all these little products that I picked together match perfectly. So I'm going to cover up completely my card front with this patterned paper that I cut out to be 4.25 by 5.5. And I'm going to use lots of foam tape at the back of all those elements to make them look more special with the dimension. Now, the roll of foam that I'm using is by Arteza. It has a great price, and I do have a 15% coupon code just in case you want to check it out. Make sure that you see the links down below in the description area. Now, I'm going to stick the card on top. Then I'm going to insert those little brushes inside the hole of my palette. I combined some glue and tape adhesive at the back, and I'm going to stick that in place. And you can call this card done, or if you want, you can go ahead and add some glossy accents. I had it on my table from the previous card, so I just had to use it one more time. I'm going over the paints to make them glossy. And they look milky at the moment, but they will dry nice and shiny. And I'm going over the words happy, just to make them pop and shine a little bit more. And here are some close-up photos on this card. For the next card, I picked this Dreamcatcher from the die cuts, and I'm going to combine it with two of the purple cards from the kit. The idea came from the one that says follow your dreams, and instead of having that Dreamcatcher, I decided to have a popped-up Dreamcatcher, so I'm mixing and matching different elements to create something similar but completely different. So I'm going to cut out the sentiment from this one, and I'm going to stick it underneath the other one. And for that, I'm going to use my Nouveau Deluxe glue, and where those two papers meet, I'm going to use a very thin strip of gold cardstock just to embellish my element a little bit more. I'm going to use my scissors to chop off the excess paper, and now at the center of this Dreamcatcher, I have foam square at the back, and that makes it sticky. So this is where I decided to stick on top a little sequin from the kit. I'm going for the silver one, but this is where I made a mistake. This foam tape is not as sticky as I thought it would be, so I need to add a dot of glue later on. You will see that in the finished photos, this little sequin has fallen off, so I need to go back and add some glue and put it back in place again. Now I'm going to combine this with one of the yellow pattern papers. I think it matches perfectly the stars on the purple pattern paper. And I'm going to stick this directly on top of my card base. Now the panel that I created is slightly smaller, since I always like to have that white border all around. I think it makes my cards look more finished, and I absolutely love this look. And that's why I love using liquid glue instead of a tape runner. It is more forgiving, so you can wiggle your papers around until you are happy with their placement. I'm going to stick a few of those golden stars. And my card is ready. For my next card, I use a rectangle die to cut out this little white panel, and I stack on top a piece of gold cardstock as well as that die cut that comes with a little arrow. You can place it at the center. And instead of sticking this arrow directly on top, I'm going to make my card a little bit more fun. So I'm going to poke a hole, and I couldn't find my crocodile, so I just had to use this tool here. And I'm going to add a little brad. This way you can easily turn the arrow around, and it can point to any of the words on top of the die cut. Now the words read cool, super, amazing, magical, and majestic in gold foiling. So I think all those words match perfectly with this puffy unicorn. This is one of the dimensional stickers. And I'm going to also stick down the word that says birthday. So you can have a cool birthday or a magical birthday, whatever that arrow, the white arrow, is pointing at. I cut down my pattern paper to be slightly smaller than my standard card, and that's 4 by 5 1/4. I'm adding glue at the back. I'm going to place it on top, having that white border. And then on top, I'm going to also stick the panel that I created. Move your arrow to point in any of the words that you like, and you are ready to go. And I think this one makes the perfect birthday card for a little girl that loves unicorns. Now let's move on to the next card, and this time I used a rectangle die as well as a circle die to cut out this little panel. I'm not going for a shaker card, I just want to have a window where I can nest inside my die cuts. I'm using this card from the kit and I'm going to stick my window on top, so I have a lovely background there. And here is another unicorn sticker that I'm going to place right inside the window. As a sentiment, I went with the word unique, and then I just created my normal background with white cardstock, a little bit of pink pattern paper, and added a few of those golden stars. And of course I have to create a flower card, so in this pack you get two die cuts of these flowers, which I'm going to use both of them just to make it look more fuller. So I'm cutting out bits and pieces so that I can tuck underneath. I'm going to stick my main flower image with foam squares at the back, so I get some dimension there, and then from the next bits and pieces that I cut out, I'm going to use glue and tuck them underneath in different areas, trying to make it look fuller. But again, this is completely optional, I just like to have dimension and fuller elements on my cards. You don't have to cut out the second die cut, you can just use it to create a similar card. Now, for the sentiment, I went with the word happy, which I'm going to stick underneath. And I'm also going to bring in a stamp set that says birthday. I'm sure you all have a sentiment that says birthday. This is from a previous card kit by Spellbinders. I absolutely love this stamp set. It has lovely words and sentiments. And now my sentiment reads happy birthday, and I'm going to combine that with this rainbow pattern paper. I think it looks super pretty and it matches the colors of the flowers. So this time I'm cut out the rainbow pattern paper to be 4.25 by 5.5. I'm placing my panel on top, stick the whole thing on top of my card base. And now I'm going to embellish the flowers a little bit more, and I will use some of those silver sequins from the kit at the center of the flowers. And here is the finished card, lovely and shiny, with lots of dimension and color, perfect for any birthday. The kit comes with lots of rainbows, so I decided to use this one with the foiling on top. This is a die cut, and there's a sticker that I absolutely love the clouds from that. It doesn't have foiling on the actual rainbow, but there is gold foiling around the clouds, which are actually dimensional. So I'm going to combine bits and pieces to create my very own element. And I end up having a bigger rainbow with foiling both on the actual rainbow and the clouds. I am going to stick down this card with foam tape, just like usual. And the rainbow is going to go on top again with foam tape. And this 3x4 card is absolutely adorable. It has all those clouds with falling hearts. So I'm going to place the rainbow on top. And now I need to add a sentiment. For that, I'm going to stamp one of the sentiments from the stamp set that says, "Never stop chasing rainbows." And I'm going to cut out this into a cloud shape. Now, if you have a die that fits that sentiment, use that. I decided to draw my own cloud, so I'm just going to use my pencil, draw it all around, and I played a little bit with this design, drawing it again and again until I was happy with the cloud that I got. I wanted it to resemble the clouds of the background paper, so now I'm using my scissors to cut it out. And if you follow this technique, don't forget to use your eraser to erase any pencil lines that are still on the cloud after drawing and cutting. I'm sticking the cloud down, and to finish off my card, I'm just going to add a little heart sticker. It's a very simple card to create, but it has so many elements on top of it, and I absolutely love that foiling. It gives something special to the card. And it is super adorable. Here are some close-up photos on this one. Now, the kit comes with a couple of white faces of cats, which I absolutely adore. I think they are super adorable and I just had to use them somehow. So I'm going to create two cards which are great for teenagers. They are really cool looking. So for this card, I'm going to mix bits and pieces from the kit. I want to have this speech bubble, so I'm just cutting it out with my scissors, leaving that purple border all around as I'm cutting it out. And I also used some dies that I had, alphabet dies, to cut out the letters that spell the word cool that you can see at the background with white cardstock. If you don't have such an option, like very tiny little alphabet dies, then you can always write it down or you can use your stamps. This is going to be my background paper. This matches perfectly with the phone. It has the phrase, "But first, let me take a selfie," written all over it. So I'm going to create a little composition there with the cat, which is laughing, the phone that has "Forever Online" written on top of it, as well as the speech bubble that says "LOL." And again, just like always, for some of my elements, I'm going with foam tape at the back, and for others, I'm going with my glue. Now, for the sentiment, I'm going to use the hashtag as well as the die cut that says "stay," which I'm going to glue directly on top of my panel. And then at the bottom, I'm going to stick the little letters that read "cool." And I'm sure that my teenage daughter is going to love this one. It combines her favorite things, including cats, as well as the phone. And the truth is that she needs cards for her friends' birthdays, but she's not into cutesy at the age that she is at the moment. So I think that she is going to love this one and the next one that I'm going to do now. Now for this one, again, I'm going to mix and match elements from the die cuts. And again, I'm going to go with that smiley cat. I absolutely adore this one. I'm going to stick this die cut in place so that I have a place where I can nest the cat on top. And for my sentiment, I'm going to use "Stay Happy." This again is a very quick and simple card to create, but I think it looks awesome. I'm going to stick one of the big golden stars. And here is the perfect background pattern paper. This one is full of cards and little speech bubbles. So I'm going to stick this on top of the other one and then on my card base. And one of the things that I absolutely love when I'm working with a kid is that you push yourself creating things that you wouldn't normally make, thinking outside of the box and ending up with such cool cards that I wouldn't otherwise create. And finally, to the last card for today. For this one, I'm going to stamp my sentiment on the white space where the cloud is, and I'm going with one of the sentiments that says, "May all your dreams come true." So this is going to be another beautiful birthday card, especially for little girls. I used black ink to stamp that. And I picked this unicorn die cut, which I'm going to pop on the right bottom corner of my panel. I'm also going to stick down this golden banner that says "Original," and there is golden foiling on the unicorn as well. So this ends up being a lovely focal point with lots of shine. But I didn't like the look directly on top of a white card base, that's why I'm going to bring in a rainbow card so that I can place it at the back, which adds a pop of color. I also added a little label sticker at the top that says "Love this." And here is the last card for today. Absolutely cute and adorable. And just like always, let's take a quick look on all the 10 cards that I made for today while using products from the February Card Kit by Spellbinders. I still have lots of pattern paper, die cuts, stickers, and many, many more of the products to make way more than 10 cards. So I hope that you had fun today, that you got inspired. Don't forget to leave me a comment down below, to like and subscribe if you haven't done so already. You will find links to everything I used down below in the description area. Thank you all so much for joining me today, and I'll see you all next time.